Brighton Lights, sponsored by the Brighton Centre, the venue for entertainment.
Welcome to Brighton Lights. I'm Joe Fuller and I'm here to tell you about great events in and around Brighton this week. My personal highlights are Tony Erdman, Anna Morris and There Will Be Blood, so keep an eye out for those. We'll be covering highlights in films, music, comedy, stage, events and gaming, so there's something for everyone. I tend to prefer shorter films, but when I saw Tony Erdman at Cine City Festival, the 2.5 hours flew by. It's poignant, difficult to watch at times, but has a superbly acted story about a father who wants to spend more time with his daughter. Dressing up as daft characters in outlandish costumes, he interrupts her social life with people not realizing who he is. It might sound contrived, but the characters are well drawn, feeling believably sad and funny. Universally acclaimed, and rightfully so, I can't recommend Tony Erdman highly enough.
Tony Erdman, nice to meet you. I'm consultant and coach.
Also das wird jetzt bestimmt die Feministin in dir ärgern, aber...
Ich bin doch keine Feministin, dann würde ich es mit Typen wie dir gar nicht aushalten, Gerald.
I have to arrest you.
Sorry, Bob, then my father made a stupid joke. Willst du mich fertig machen, oder was?
Wenn es um ihren Vater geht, dann bin ich nicht der Richtige.
Ach, kriegt sie doch alle!
Bist du eigentlich ein bisschen glücklich hier?
Schwören jetzt ganz schön viele Begriffe rum hier, ne? Spaß, Glück, Leben. Was findest denn du lebenswert?
Ja, da muss man das noch machen und dies und dann und währenddem geht das Leben einfach vorbei.
The Reconnaissance rumbles on with Gold, a film supposedly based on the true story of the Briex mining scandal in 1993. Disregarding the accuracy, however, Matthew McConaughey and Edgar Ramirez's performances have been praised, although some reviews have been mixed, so tread with caution.
Kenny, look, we got a gold mine.
For better or worse, the ride had begun. And what a ride.
I never doubted you for a second.
This is Ryan Wolf in New York.
They were coming at me from all sides.
From Jeff Nichols, the director of Mud and Midnight Special, comes another film based on a true story, although this one might be a bit more considered in its historical accuracy. The drama revolves around an interracial marriage that violated Virginia's anti-miscegenation laws and the couple's battle to be legally wed.
In here?
Richie!
What you doing in bed with that woman?
I'm his wife.
That's no good here.
Richard Perry Loving being a white person and Mildred Jeter being a colored person did unlawfully cohabitate as man and wife.
Richard?
That ain't right!
I believe this is a battle that could go all the way to the Supreme Court.
We ain't hurting anybody.
The state of Virginia will argue that it is unfair to bring children of mixed race into the world.
Tell that woman to come out of here.
I'm gonna raise my family here. I don't care what they do to us.
Get Peggy inside!
Set 13 years after the events of the first Ring film, this one sees a new young woman on the end of a curse which threatens to take her life in 7 days. Hopefully this one can recapture some of the fun of the first film, although the fact that it's a sequel might diminish the strength of the original idea. It could be a fun night out though if thrills and chills are your cup of tea.
I keep thinking about this story. There's this video that kills you 7 days after you watch it. The second it's over, the phone rings, and this voice says,
7 days.
is when she's coming for me.
7 days. You want to know about the girl in the well?
C. Duncan reminded me of the brilliant band Paper Cuts with his debut album Architect, which was released in 2015. He's gone more experimental and electronic with his second album, The Midnight Sun, however. Recent single Other Side still retains the poppy sensibilities and prominent vocals of his earlier work. You'll be pleased to hear that it's my birthday this Sunday, and to celebrate, I'll be watching the Brighton Philharmonic Orchestra at Brighton Dome. They'll be playing Mozart Symphony No. 29, Haydn's Cello Concerto No. 1, and Mendelssohn's Italian Symphony. I love Mendelssohn's music. It's got beautiful, bold melodies, but also emotional depth and musical heft. You can hear the first theme of this Italian symphony in the following clip. The 10-piece Big Chris Barber Band perform various styles from New Orleans to blues to Duke Ellington. The song titles are great, including Bourbon Street Parade, Jubilee Stomp, Petite Fleur, and more. For those unfamiliar with big band music, here is a clip to see what you can expect. Boxed In are a soft, wispy, poppy electronic act that remind me a bit of Hot Chip, Chet Faker and Son. This gig could be a good shout for anyone who's into this sort of music, and their records have drawn support from Radio 1 and 6 Music, so they are popular. If you want to forget, yeah, if you want to. If you want to, I'll let you. If you want to. If you want to forget, yeah, if you want to. If you want to. Coming soon, Lord of the Dance, Dangerous Games returns to the Brighton Centre after its popular 2015 tour. Flatley's protégés, James Keegan, Morgan Cummer and Matthew Smith will star, and if you were lucky enough to see the previous tour, then you'll still be able to enjoy new staging, costumes and choreography, as well as new music by composer Gerard Fahey. Patrick Hamilton wrote the play Rope, which was chillingly adapted for the screen by Hitchcock. Gaslight is considered by some to be one of the greatest stage thrillers of all time, and this production stars television actress Cara Toynton. Also starring is Rupert Young from the BBC's Merlin, and Keith Allen stars as Detective Ruff, which I love as a fine Dickensian name.
Hi, I'm Cara Toynton. I'm thrilled to be doing Gaslight. Today we've been doing the photo shoot for the sort of ad campaign. I think what I'm most looking forward to about this play is looking into a young woman whose mind is slowly being manipulated and tampered with by her husband. And so she starts to believe she's going slightly mad.
You probably know the book The Very Hungry Caterpillar by Eric Carle, but the story is now coming to the stage. Created by Jonathan Rockefeller, the acclaimed production features 75 puppets and also includes other Carle stories such as Mr. Seahorse and The Very Lonely Firefly. Ross Noble has a quick, freewheeling style of stand-up comedy that might even win over those not typically too fussed about comedy. He has over 25 years of experience, and his new show is subtitled Brain Dump, so we can expect some high-quality, intelligent rambling and his trademark flights of fancy.
Is it you, like, walked into some sort of Friends of the Earth meeting, haven't you? Everyone in here's just... No, we cycled or jogged here this evening. Yes, we came by alternative ecological modes of transport. I came on a donkey. Well, I think it was fine. Yes, I came on a pogo stick. Well, I fitted four pogo sticks to the bottom of a donkey, didn't it?
That's all for part one. Don't go anywhere because we have comedy, events and gaming after the break.
Brighton Lights, sponsored by the Brighton Centre, the venue for entertainment. Brighton Lights, sponsored by the Brighton Centre, the venue for entertainment.
Welcome back to Brighton Lights Part 2. I'm Joe Fuller and I'm now going to tell you about more good stuff that you can go to. I saw this show at Edinburgh Fringe last year and it was great. A finely crafted, bitter critique of someone obsessed with a privileged notion of perfection. Georgina is more than a crude character, however. The whole work has a real heart and a great message behind it, as well as a fantastic comic actor in Anna Morris. You can see what Georgina is like from the following wedding invitation.
Hello, I'm Georgina and I am engaged.
The Rope Tackle Arts Centre in Shoreham are hosting Lee Nelson for a special work in progress show. Testing brand new material ahead of his tour, it's a chance to see him in a smaller venue for a smaller fee.
Good evening, Apollo! Yes! Oh, people, I have had such a nice day today. It was my little boy's sixth birthday. Yeah! We don't have a lot of money, so we didn't tell him. It is odd being a parent, people. Mums, especially mum, my poor missus, she always looking in the mirror. Oh my gosh, my body ain't what like it was before the kids come along. I say, babes, you're being so silly. You weren't all that before.
James Acaster presents a trilogy where he performs material from his first three shows, Recognize, Represent, and Reset. His jokes are carefully constructed and perfectly timed, plus he's simply very funny, as you can see from the following clip.
About a friend of mine, he works in a casino, and one day he, is dice plural and die singular? Or is die plural? And anyway, he killed two people by mistake. Say he's my friend. He's not really my friend. I'm on the jury. I shouldn't say friend, should I? I shouldn't say friend. I mean, I'm very clear, he's not your friend, mate. I see him every day, he seems like a nice guy. There's someone else called James on the jury. Got confusing how we got round it, right? Everyone would call him James One and me Wolf. I've got to choose my own name. Me and James One hit the town, cutting it up. I was making an effort once, dressed to impress, had my best tie on. Paisley makes the girls go crazily.
Miles Jupp's new show, Songs of Freedom, is described by him as a rant about me, you, domestic imprisonment, the government, and lots of other things to be fretting about. A calmer comedy night out, then, with a carefully paced delivery. You can read more about the show in an interview online at thelatest.co.uk.
You probably all recognise me as the waiter who had all of his lines cut from the first Sherlock Holmes film. And then didn't find out until the premiere. Nonetheless, it was a portrayal that has since revolutionised the way everyone acts in period detective fiction when they've got nothing to say. I've arrived here tonight, as I suspect you have, as I arrive everywhere. I arrive in London furious. I mean, you can all see how angry I am. Very angry man. Whenever I'm trying to get anywhere in London, I get angry. You know, if I'm on a bus that's late or a tube that seems to stop without explanation or there's just a traffic jam, I always get angry. And I always blame the same person. I don't even know if it's fair, but I always blame Boris. Right?
The self-professed clown in a gown, Bianca Del Rio, is bringing her stand-up show, Not Today, Satan, to Brighton for the first time. The season 6 winner of RuPaul's Drag Race has been called the Joan Rivers of the drag world. It's sold out, so you'll need to keep an eye out for returns or resales on social media or the Dome ticket office.
So this is my closet. As you can see, I'm very understated. I don't like color. I like simple, plain, natural things.
Oh, it's too much! I can't take it! Too much? I was gonna say, the one, the only, Bianca Del Rio.
Baby got back.
Yes! Wait a minute! Wait a minute!
Baby got back.
You know, listen, I could never be a Kardashian because I have talent. All right!
DJ Sunny Federa headlines the first take of the year on the South Coast at the Arch Club. Sunny is touring the UK, USA and Australia with over 30 dates, so this is a great chance to see an internationally renowned DJ in Brighton this weekend. Other DJs include Paul S, Maxine Garman and Adam Barnett. There Will Be Blood is a truly sublime film by Paul Thomas Anderson, and you have a unique chance to watch it with a live score at the Dome. The soundtrack includes music from Radiohead's Johnny Greenwood and also bits from Arvo Pärt's staggeringly beautiful music, Fratres. The 55-strong London Contemporary Orchestra will include the Ond Martino, which is a rare synth-like instrument that will be played by an expert in Cynthia Miller. You can read more in an interview on thelatest.co.uk, and you can get a feel for the event from the following enigmatic trailer. There's something comforting and reassuring about the next game, Poochie and Yoshi's Woolly World, out this week on Nintendo 3DS. You have the Mellow mode for more relaxed players, but a Dash mode if you want a speedier platforming experience. I played the original Yoshi's Woolly World on the Wii U, and it was a fun, sweet co-op platformer, so we can expect similar quality from the portable version. The most recent Hitman game was released episodically, but this physical steelbook edition collects all of them in a neat package. There's over 100 hours of intelligent stealth gameplay spread across the prologue, France, Italy, Morocco, Thailand, USA, and Japan. The trailer should give you an idea of the enigmatic James Bond-like tone.
People die, Mr. Fannin. Happens all the time, even to us. And yet, there was a pattern, and I failed to see it. Someone knows about us.
Italy. Morocco. Paris. Someone's playing a game, 47. The question is, against whom?
This is your gift. And your curse.
Originally released 20 years ago, Management Game Constructor gets an HD remaster and is out this week. You build homes and businesses, but also have to manage the so-called undesirables, which creates some interesting game mechanics. For example, you can use Mr. Fix-It to botch gas supplies, or even use maniacal clowns to scare away your enemies. And finally, a quick game review of Final Fantasy XV, which is now available a bit cheaper. I'm a huge Final Fantasy fan, and this is the title that has grabbed me the most since Final Fantasy IX. The battle mechanic is exciting, but simple enough not to get in the way of the game's momentum. The open world looks beautiful, and the four main characters are funny and memorable. Sadly, the story is often unintelligible and poorly written, and the linear second half of the game feels rushed and clumsy, and there's this really bonkers bit with Resident Evil-type horror stuff that doesn't really work. Still, it's a strong Final Fantasy tale that I happily poured about 50 hours of my life into, and I'll probably come back to it, so I'll give it 8 out of 10.
The beacon of light in a world of chaos. But now, we are broken. Filled by the lies of our enemies. My son, my heir, you are the key to our redemption. Only you can restore the light. Only you can reclaim the throne.
That's all we've got time for today. Thanks a lot for watching. If you have any shows that you'd like to be considered for a mention on Brighton Lights, then you can email me at editorial@thelatest.co.uk.
Brighton Lights, sponsored by the Brighton Centre, the venue for entertainment.